Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler.
Hi, I'm Joni, the teardrop nanny. We're here today at the Malell Dunes. There's a north side and a south side, and they're managed cooperatively by two different entities. We're here on the south side, which is managed by the Bureau of Land Management. This was once a cultural and sacred area to the Wiat people. It's a chance to see a very diverse, unique landscape, sloughs, ocean, bay, dunes. We're going to cook up a blue plate special.
Featuring antelope burger. Stay tuned.
For today's blue plate burger special, here are some of the ingredients that I'm using. An egg, a couple of green onions with their tops, breadcrumbs, some prepared mustard, some brown gravy. You can make your own, use a can, use a jar, package mix. You'll also need a little bit of water, some horseradish, a half a pound of fresh mushrooms, and today's blue plate burgers include some antelope burger. My brother Jim got some antelope from Wyoming and had it processed there. So thank you to Bighorn Meat Cutting, who packed up these 1 pound chubs for us. Burger like this is generally a lot less in fat, so we're going to be adding some things into it to make it a cohesive and stick together burger. The cooking setup I'm using today for the cast iron skillet includes a cookie sheet with about 14 coals right now underneath. When I use the skillet over the coals directly, I oftentimes put a rack on top, and today I'll be using this wire rack with the skillet. Anytime I fix a wild game into a burger, I always like to use an egg. Whether it be elk, venison, moose, in this case antelope, I'll beat one egg. I also put in some kind of a binder, like a breadcrumb or an oatmeal. After I beat that one egg, I'll stir in two of the sliced green onions, tops and all. Venison burger and elk, I like to use yellow onion. Half a cup of some seasoned breadcrumbs. You can use this recipe with burger of pretty much any type. If you like beef burgers, check out our legendary Bigfoot burger. It has how to prepare the smash burger as well as how to make your own hamburger buns. We also have how to cure the hamburger blues. The last part of this mixture will be 1 tablespoon of prepared yellow mustard. Stir this up well, mix in that egg. The next step is to add your meat, whether it be beef or some kind of wild game. Add your meat in, 1.5 to 2 pounds, and mix it up well. This antelope burger was processed by Bighorn Meat Cutting out of Buffalo, Wyoming. As you can see, it doesn't have a lot of fat in it. I'm going to use about 2 pounds of the burger, or 2 chubs worth. There's the first chub of meat, and this is the second one going in. So mix up those breadcrumbs, eggs, onions, and mustard. Then you'll form them into patties. Each of these will be around 1/2 pound of patty, 4 burgers in all. After a couple minutes, everything should be thoroughly mixed in there. and ready to shape some burger patties. To form the patties, while that skillet's heating up, I took the meat and pressed it down in the bowl, and then I take to make it equal and uniform and score it, because I will be doing four burgers, and I want them to be approximately the same size. Each of those will be shaped into a patty. With these half-pound burgers, each of the patties will be approximately a half to three-quarters of an inch thick. Once I get the patty formed, I often will take and make a depression like this in the center, because then the meat in the center will get done and it does puff up when it cooks. These four patties are finished and ready to go into that skillet that's been warming up. Right now I'm going to cook up three of these. I'll cook them about 4 to 5 minutes on each side until the meat inside is no longer pink. Time to flip them. And in case you're wondering why I held that one burger back and didn't cook it up, my brother Jim, who got us the antelope, he's coming over tomorrow, so I'll cook him up his burger fresh. In a medium-sized bowl, I've combined the brown gravy, a couple teaspoons of prepared horseradish, and water into this bowl. I'll be stirring in the mushrooms. I'll add this mixture into the skillet on top of the patties. If you find that your skillet has some fat in it, drain it first, then replace the patties back in it and pour over the mushroom mixture. Put this mushroom mixture over your patties and continue to cook it for 5 minutes uncovered or until your mushrooms become tender. Here it is about 5 minutes later, and it's ready to be plated up as the Blue Plate Special, with or without a bun. Here you have it from the Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking Diner, the Blue Plate Special. Season to taste, add the condiments that you like, and I like mine to be about medium to medium rare, perfect inside. Here on the north side, again, you get the very diverse landscape. This has the slough and trails. We hope you enjoyed today's webisode. I'd like to give a shout out to those guides and outfitters that helped my brother get that antelope. Thanks to Rob. See below the links for the outfitters.
Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
Until the next time, happy trails to you.